We're going to find the oxidation number for all the atoms in sodium silicate, Na2SiO3. There are three types of atom present in this compound, which are Na, Si, and O. And we can easily find their oxidation numbers using these rules. According to rule number 3, the oxidation number of O in a compound is negative 2. So we've just found the oxidation number for oxygen, which is negative 2. Now, what about Na and Si? If we follow the first part of rule number 4, which is sum of the oxidation number for compound is equals to 0, it'll be a little bit difficult for us to find the oxidation number for Na and Si because we can't solve an equation with two unknowns in one equation. So what we're going to have to do is we're going to have to break this compound down. And because Na2SiO3 is an ionic compound consisting of sodium metal and a polyatomic ion, which is silicate ion, so we're going to break it down and that's going to give us Na plus because Na comes from group 1 metal and group 1 metals form a plus 1 charge. And knowing that, that's going to give us the charge for our silicate ion, which is SiO3 2 minus. Now, in case you don't know how to figure this out, let me just show you real quick how we do that. We can find out the charge by looking at the formula of the ionic compound, which is Na2SiO3. So looking at this, we have 1 of SiO3, correct? Because it's Na2SiO3. So I'll just put a bracket 1 there. And we're going to do a reverse engineer. So that means we have Na plus and SiO3 with some negative charge. Because we know it's an ionic compound. Ionic compound is formed from positive ion and negative ion. So Na is plus 1, confirmed. SiO3, we don't know what's the charge. So now what we're going to do is do a reverse crossover method. And that's going to give us the charge for silicate ion. Notice when you cross over the 2, we know that the charge for SiO3 is actually 2 minus. I'll link a video on finding charge for ions if you're interested to dive deeper. Now let's go back to finding the oxidation number for Na and Si. So since Na is a monoatomic ion, that means the oxidation number for Na is plus 1. Next, we can move on to finding the oxidation number for Si. We'll use rule number 4 for polyatomic ion. So we set X to represent the oxidation number for Si, and now we have X plus 3 times negative 2 equals negative 2. The reason we have 3 in front is because we have 3 oxygen, and we times 2 because negative 2 is the oxidation number for oxygen. And the whole thing, we add it up and we equate it to negative 2 because that is the charge for our silicate ion. Solving that is going to give us X is plus 4. Which means the oxidation number for Si is plus 4. With that, we found the oxidation number for Na, Si, and O in Na2SiO3. Hope that helps. Do subscribe and thanks for watching.